Hello, this is Benji.js. I'm Benji, and today I'd like to show you that anyone who can write HTML can create a virtual reality scene using the framework A-Frame. First, I'm going to show you A-Frame's website. It's a-frame.io, and you can see on here they have some examples. We're going to be creating something similar to this. So it is a 3D scene using behind the scenes, A-Frame uses 3.js, and if you happen to have a mobile device and a Google Cardboard headset, you can pull up examples like this on your phone and tap this little button, and you'll be able to explore the world in first person 3D. Okay, to get started, we are going to find an A-Frame CDN, which I just do by searching for A-Frame CDN on Google. A CDN, if you don't know, is a content delivery network, which is basically a way to make files available globally at high speed with high availability. Just going to click this result here and scroll down, and here are links to A-Frame itself and also a minified version of A-Frame. If you're not familiar with minified files, they have been compressed such that they've lost a lot of legibility, but also they can be downloaded more quickly. We're going to be using just the regular A-Frame file, because if we do end up needing to debug inside of A-Frame itself, it'll make it a lot easier. So I just have an empty index.html file here. I'm going to create a script tag and set the source to the path that we just copied. So what's awesome about A-Frame, as I said before, is you can create a VR scene just using HTML tags. The first thing you need is the A-Scene tag, and then inside of that, you can build other shapes, like a sphere. I'm gonna back up a little bit, and hey, look, there's a sphere. Kind of hard to see because it's a white sphere on a white background, but we can just use HTML attributes to change the sphere color to whatever we want. So I'm just gonna make it black for now. Or, you know, you can use hex code, or you can use any sort of styling string that you can use with CSS. I think you can use with A-Frame as well. So now here we have a red sphere, and as I promised, we have created a virtual reality scene on the web using only HTML. I know, not too exciting as it is, I still think it shows that A-Frame is a really powerful tool. Now, if you're a JavaScript developer, and I'm sure most of you are, you're probably thinking right now, huh, I could set those attributes programmatically, and that's actually exactly what we're gonna do next. So I'm gonna add another script tag, and I'm gonna set it to a local index.js file, which I'm gonna create right now. And the first thing I think I'm gonna do is set up a little shortcut for selecting DOM elements. The API will look basically like jQuery. We're gonna use document.querySelector, which is the query selector that's built into JavaScript. And we're gonna pass it a query string, and we're gonna return what that returns. So now if we wanted to set the color of that sphere, we can just say $asphere.setAttributeColor, and let's say we want to make it blue. We do that, and hey, look, it's blue now. Now, I don't want to have to adjust the camera every single time that we change a property. I'm going to go ahead and set the X, Y, and Z position of the sphere to a value I happen to know that will center it in our camera view. This is X, Y, Z. Now, obviously, just setting the color once programmatically isn't super exciting. So what I think we should do is change the color over time using a programmatic animation. The way you do animation in JavaScript is with a built-in function called requestAnimationFrame, which will accept a callback. RequestAnimationFrame will fire the callback when the browser's ready, and it can do that up to 60 times per second. So we're going to create a function here to pass as our callback. We're just going to call it animate. It's not going to be doing much animating as of yet, but we'll get there. And then you also want to call requestAnimationFrame within your callback so that it keeps firing endlessly. And again, pass animate into requestAnimationFrame. And then the last thing you need to do is call requestAnimationFrame and pass in your animation function. No, whoops, typed that wrong. Okay, so now it should be setting our sphere to blue 60 times a second. Instead of setting it to blue 60 times a second though, we want to set it to a new color 60 times a second. So I'm gonna create a new function called shift hue. It's going to take an integer that represents a hue as a value from 1 to 360 degrees. And it'll just return that hue plus 1. We're going to use modulus 360 so that the value never goes over 360. We're going to create a state variable for our hue, start it out at 0. And then every frame, we're going to create a new hue, which is going to be, we're going to use HSL because that's just an intuitive way to build colors for me. The first value is the hue. Second value is saturation, which I'm going to put at 100%. And the last value is lightness, which I'm going to put at 50%. And we're actually going to build that string with the return value from shift hue. So it'll start out at 0, then the next frame it'll be 1, the next frame it'll be 2, so on until 360, at which point it will set itself back to 0. The last thing to do here is set the color. Well, let's call this color, not hue. And we'll set the color to that color. Oh, we also need to be setting the value of hue every frame. So let's do it this way. Shift hue, hue. And then we can pass hue directly in here. Hey, check that out. Now our color is changing over time. Another thing we might want to animate is the position. So I'm going to go ahead and grab our starting position. We'll set up a variable to hold our position. We will set the position each frame. And that shouldn't change anything yet. But then we're going to change this position to be a string template. And we're going to update the Y value every frame. We're going to make it 1.5 plus, let's say, math.sign and pass in date.now, which will give us how many milliseconds have passed since January 1st, 1970 or something like that. Let's see what that does. It's a little fast. Let's divide what we get back from date.now by, let's say, 1,000 and see what that does. Ah, that's pretty nice. And of course, this is a VR application, so we can look all around it if we want. We can pull it up in our Google Cardboard and see it in 3D. It would be nice if we had some sort of a grounding effect to give the sphere some context. So let's add a plane below it. Just gonna add the A plane tag here. We can get rid of the color we're setting on our sphere since we're setting that programmatically now. We can do the same with the position actually. We will need to set its rotation. We'll rotate it along the x-axis. The reason for that is that it starts out standing upright. We want it to be flat because it's going to be the ground. And let's set it to black just so we can see it. Looks like we want to push it back in the Z position. Maybe also set the width and height. Let's do this first. So X, Y, Z. Width 10, height 10. Remember we're using height because it starts out like this and we've rotated it. Let's do this. And I'm gonna go ahead and set the color of our plane to match that of our sphere. Might be fun to spin it around. So let's pull out the rotation. I'm going to go ahead and capture this value, call it variation. That way we can reuse it with our rotation. And we'll make this one 90 times variation. Let's see what that does. Whoa, check it out. Our platform is rotating. And I'm just gonna do one more thing. One thing that I like to do is go to jiffy.com and just grab some random image. I happen to have found one I like for this. You can set the texture of your 3D objects by setting the source to an image. If we reload one more time. Chris Farley is really into this experiment. So I'm hoping that after seeing this, you're getting pretty excited about the possibilities, imagining all sorts of really cool stuff you can do with A-Frame. I know I have been excited about it myself. I've actually released kind of a funny little project where anybody can hop onto the metaverse, set their texture to a GIF, and run around with other people. Once again, I would love any feedback on the video. Always happy to hear your thoughts, and let me know if you have any questions in the comments, and I'll be happy to answer them. Thanks, and have a good one.